So let's take an in-depth look at the problem many people are having where they're getting spam in their calendar app. So it's very easy to invite anybody to anything in calendar. For instance, let's create an event, call it test, and I can add invitees right here and I can type anything I want, any email address to include them. I don't have to know them. I don't have to actually even know if that's a valid email address. I can just send it and it will go out, and if that's a real iCloud email address, even if it's not iCloud.com because you can have an Apple ID that's any domain name, the person at the other end will get an invite. And that makes it very easy to invite somebody without having to have everybody logged into the same system and having set up something in advance. But it also opens up the calendar system to spam, because somebody you don't know can send you a piece of spam as a calendar event. It could have a link in it. It could have a sales pitch in it. All of that. So what people are getting are these. So I'm actually going to send myself a piece of this spam from another account I've got, just so you can see. So on another Mac, I have set up an event and I've invited this Apple ID, a different one that's logged in to the first Mac, to the event. And what's going to happen is I'm going to get the invite. It's going to appear here, and it'll appear as an alert that I can accept or close. And closing just dismisses it for now, but it's still in the calendar and I can see it here as an alert that's coming to the calendar, and I can see it in gray here as an event I've not yet accepted. I can click here and I can maybe, which basically doesn't do anything, it's the event's still going to sit there, I can decline it or accept it. Now either way, the problem is that whoever sent it to me is going to get a notification that the invite was accepted or invite was declined. And this is what worries a lot of people. But it doesn't worry me so much, because I've looked at these and they seem to be pieces of spam. They want you to click on the link. Hitting decline and getting rid of it will notify them that your iCloud account is at that Apple ID. But there's really not much harm in this, especially if you're doing what you're supposed to do and using two-factor authentication and a strong password. Then really just knowing that your Apple ID exists isn't going to put you in any danger. Matter of fact, they really do know your Apple ID already exists because they sent you this email. Chances are they're not sending to randomly generated iCloud email addresses. They're actually sending to a list. You're probably getting spam from other places. So declining, I don't really see the harm in it, because as long as you're using two-factor and strong password, declining it isn't really going to hurt you in any way. But if you really wanted to get rid of this without them seeing that you declined it, then the way to do it is this. You want to create a new calendar, call it junk or temp, or just leave it as untitled, whatever you want. Take this and drag it to that calendar. Now this is part of that new calendar, and you can see it's got one waiting request there. I am going to then select this calendar. I'm going to actually let some control click on it. Delete it. The calendar will give you an option to delete and don't notify. And there you go. So every time you get one of these, you have to create a new calendar. You drag and drop the invitation to that new calendar. Then you control click, delete, and say don't notify. And now there's no notification, but you've gotten rid of that quietly. I haven't been doing this because it's a lot of extra steps. I just hit decline and I move on. But there's a better way to handle it, so you don't even have to deal with these in calendar at all. In Safari, you go to iCloud.com. So now you have access to all your stuff, but in web-based form rather than in the apps. But you can go into calendar, and in calendar you'll see a little settings button here at the bottom left. Click on that and then go to preferences, and under preferences go to advanced. And here you can change the behavior of iCloud.com to, instead of sending you event invitations as in-app notifications, so you see them appear inside of the calendar app, send them to you instead as emails. Emails are easily deleted without notifying anybody, and you're probably used to deleting emails that you don't want or are spam anyway. It's just simply just hitting the delete key. So it's a lot easier to get rid of them that way. So until Apple fixes this problem, and I have no doubt that they will come up with a good solution, you just switch over to this, and then you'll get your invites as emails. Unless you get tons of invites from people, this shouldn't really be too much of an inconvenience to most of us. This is what I'm doing to combat this type of spam. And it's what I recommend as well.